We hit it right. Oh, we didn't hit it right. This is superb. What God is doing, I'm waking out of sleep. My heart about to explode with the joy. But my Bible tell me in the presence of the Almighty God, joy rests on the same. There's so many great miracles that's going to happen in your life. I speak by testimony and by the unction of the Holy Spirit and by the word of God that is true and faithful. All I need to do is hear, receive it, and believe it. It's 3 o'clock in the morning. That lets you know, God, you never sleep, not during slumber. That man, I'm telling you, he's watching over you, sweetheart. If you sound asleep, angels are assigned to watch over you all night long. And when you rise up in the morning, the angel's still right there, waiting up on you. I'm telling you, well, thus said the Lord, oh, I need you to get on my car and believe God and take him at his word. If God love us just that much to wake the prophet about to sleep, to tell you what thus said the Lord, because what's going to happen is nothing but an exodus. I want you to X everything else out, exclude anything and all things that's not glorifying God. I want you to get it from your path, because the Lord has made the crooked path straight. I felt it down in my bones. He has made the crooked path straight. God has moved so supernaturally on your behalf, it's just going to knock you off your feet. Just a couple of weeks ago, my feet was almost, the toe, the big toe, was almost severed off. That's why you couldn't hear from me for the past 2 weeks. Because in fact, God gave me time to heal and so forth and so forth. But God said, you get up and you go pray and you release in the atmosphere the power of the Almighty God that's moving as I speak. The power. See, anytime the devil try to come in and distract, that's because the fact God is right there to move on your behalf. God himself has already spoken, and he said, today, this is your moment, this is your hour, this is your second, and this is your season. That God said to you right now, rise up, because you're about to see the power of the living God manifest on your behalf. Don't care what it look like, don't care what it sound like. You know, between you and God, once y'all connect together, you become a powerful force, because God is a force all by himself. And this is what the Lord is saying. When you and God, all things are made possible. When you and God, you better hear the Holy Spirit, because there's a whirlwind of God's glory. There's a whirlwind of God's goodness. There's a whirlwind of God. Oh, my God, I'm trying to hold myself in this seat, because in fact, God is getting ready to blow your mind. Are you hearing the Holy Spirit? Because God had on your mind from the first beginning. He said, listen up, I know your ending from the beginning. All I need you to do is stick with me. All I need you to do, believe in what I tell you. All I need you to do, grab hold of what I'm saying. All I need you to do, obey what I tell you. All I need you to do, are you hearing the Holy Spirit? God talking to you. And ain't nothing in hell the devil could do about it. He can't stop it. He can't shake it. He can't rock it. Ain't nothing he can do with it. But bow down to the God that's on the inside of you. It's like an emergency message. Listen to the wisdom. Like an emergency message. Yeah, let me tell you something. Even in the pain, as I was sitting in the hospital, listen to wisdom. Even in the pain, sitting in the hospital, the power of God began to move. The power of God began to manifest. The power of God, let me tell you what's about to happen. There's a divine connection is getting ready to take place. And that divine connection is going to bring you where God promised that he has already brought you. In other words, God always speaks in past tense. In other words, he always speaks knowing that it's already done. He said, all I need you to do is take me at my word. Believe what I tell you. Believe what I say. Don't you let nothing get inside your ear, your spirit, to contaminate your faith. I'm about the power of God. I'm trying to hold myself down in this chair. I know it's got to be after 3 o'clock in the morning, but that's all right. By the power and authority of the Almighty God, you're going to see the hand of God move on your behalf. And he's moving right now in a supernatural way. It's your faith to set things in action. It's your faith to activate the promises. It's your faith saying, but Lord, I will not deny. Let me tell you something. that God said, tell you. I mean, you never pray to a God that you don't trust. Oh, but you got to use this wisdom. You don't ever pray to a God that you don't trust. You see, the God that I serve, the God that you serve, I don't know your level of maturity. Only you know what elevated you are on. But nothing come before my Father. Nothing come. I don't care what it is. I don't care who it is. God got an assignment. Nobody's name is on it but you. God has supernatural breakthroughs. Nobody's name is on it but you. God has supernatural moves. Nobody's on it. Only your name is on this breakthrough, what God has done for you in your life. In 2022, baby, your life will never look the same. Give God a little time, because if in the midst of the time, there's a process going on. And when that process, God knows when it's ready, because he knows when it's ripe. R-I-P-E. He knows when it's ripe. And when it's ripe, that means it's time for the outburst to take his place. And this is what God is saying right now. It's time for the outburst to take his place. You better hear God. It's coming all down in my heart, talking to you. Thus said the Lord. Hear God and hear God well. God is saying to tell you, the most powerful force in the universe is the power of the faith. Is the power of you believing. Is the power of your knowing. Is the power that's greater than any other power that ever exists. What you mean, Pastor Simon? God has equipped you, glory be to God. He has equipped you to get the job done. Oh yeah, he may have to set you down for a little while because of the fact he needs you to regroup. So when God comes back through you, that means, baby, he ain't coming back the same. God is supernatural moving on your behalf. Don't let that line defeat you, low down, good for nothing. Devil deceive you. He only deceive you because of the fact he know ignorance will cause you to miss out. But if I were you, I would recognize that line defeat the devil. How about to stop? Because it's always speaking contrary to what God has already spoken to you. And this is why God said, get up, because he woke me up in joy. Tell my people, everything is already all right. Tell my people, it's already been settled. Tell my people, it's already been finished. Tell my people, it's already done. Tell my people, glory be to God. Tell my people, because God got your heart. God got your heart. You better hear the Holy Spirit. God got your heart in the palm of his hand. And whom God hold in the palm of his hand, can a devil in hell break you from out of the hand of God. Because when God holds you, ain't no letting you go. Now you can run, that's the only way. But other than that, I don't care how stinky it may smell, how bad it may look. It doesn't matter when it comes down to the promises of the Almighty God. I can get up and begin to run because the power of God's moving, moving all in my bone, moving all in my mind, moving all down in my oroco. God is moving right now. Take it, glory be to God. This is the day that God has moved, and not a weapon gonna fall over the local fire, form up against you and prosper. Not a weapon in hell. Are you hearing the Holy Spirit? God himself, you better hear God. He is in all power. He is in all authority. He is the all-knowing. He is your Father, and he will see everything he spoke to you. He will see it come to pass, and you're gonna take one thing. It's the only thing you're gonna take this morning, and that's your faith to believe. You're gonna believe it. If you feel yourself feeling a little weakened, you tell God, Lord, I feel a little weakened in my faith, because my Bible says that it's because of the faith that's activated out of your heart and out of your mouth. It called mountains to bow down to you. It calls heathen to bow down to you. It causes everything sickness and disease to bow down to you. Nobody understand the pain that God allowed me to feel, but oh, when the time was up, he woke me up and I didn't have a crutch. He woke me up. He said, I get up and go pray. He woke me up and said, you go release this over my people, because everything I spoke it, not the one word will fall to the ground. And this is what David said. David said, Lord, all the stuff I've gone through in my life, Lord, you telling me you gonna bless me like this? God said, yeah, it has nothing to do with your words. It has everything to do with your obedience. When God called you out, when God gives you an assignment, when God said, carry through. Let me tell you something. He's not as man, glory be to God. This man, he's so powerful. You looking for him to come this way, he to turn the thing all the way around in your favor. And he come in a whole different direction, baby. All you got to do is stay settled with him. Settle with this little son, boy. Settle with that man. Settle with that peace. Settle with that joy. joy. Celebrate it, glory be to God. Even if you don't understand it, celebrate it anyhow, because my God don't make no mistakes. And Paul said it like this. He said, I may not know all things. He said, but rest assured, by and by, the time gonna come, I will know everything that I need to know. But right now, all you need to know right now is God is on your side. God is right here ready to deliver you. God is saying right now, I hold you in the palm of my hand, and can't no evil defeat, ain't no devil in hell got the power to take you out of God's hands unless you relinquish your rights and say, well, I don't know. I hate the devil. I hate him, because you know what his cause is? His cause is to get you to doubt God. You know how you know you doubt God? Because now you begin to question God. You begin trying to understand God. And the devil trying to set you up. Because the biblical part of God that I serve, he's a God of mysterious. You cannot understand this God. You cannot. But let me tell you something. He didn't make Bridget to understand him. He made Bridget to know him. And to know him by his word. And to know him by the word of faith. To know him. Glory be to God. You hear the word. You meditate on the word. You speak and believe what you believe. Are you hearing the Holy Spirit? There's an outpouring, glory. Oh, but I can take the robe off, because there's an outpouring. His biblical power has already been in place. God has set it so in place right now for you. It's like a smooth ride. Gonna come on, bring you through. Ain't nothing in hell gonna hold back. But God has promised you, all you got to do is hook up with my Father. Hook up with God the Father. Hook up with God the Son. Hook up with God the Holy Ghost. That's the bad boy going to get the job done. That's the man. You better hear the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit right now listens to everything that I'm speaking. He's listening to every thought that you're thinking, because of the fact he know the one that believe. He know the one that don't believe. He know it. Glory be to God. Everybody worshiping the same God and ain't getting no, and it's not getting no results. You tell that devil, God said you lying, defeated for you. He said, listen up, I defeated you once. I defeated you twice, and by God, I'm getting ready to defeat you again, because of the fact that your victory came when he was on that cross, and he told that man on the other side, he said, today, you're going to meet me in paradise. What you mean, Pastor Stiver? That means that in paradise is where all the righteous souls at one time went. But my Bible said, with my little boy, when my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ rose up, glory be to God, my Bible said, he asked the Let me tell you something. He ascended. He descended. Thank the Holy Spirit. He descended before he ascended. That means that he had to go down, glory be to God, and curse every curse that the devil thought he has assigned out to you. But oh, but I'm here to tell you right now this morning that every curse already been reversed. I'm telling you, you're messing with a true child of God, and you know that it's God telling you, you better back up off of my anointed one, because you're not going to like your end results. But my mind chooses to focus on the word and the power and authority of the Almighty God. I dare you to say, Lord, I receive it. I dare you to say, God, I receive it. I dare you to say, God, I know it's my time. I dare you to say, God, I know it's for me. I dare you to say it, glory be to God. I dare you to say that, because God is moving. This man is on a loose. It's like I can't explain it, but I can tell you only what he allowed me to see. Because my Bible tell me that Paul said it like this, I may know in parts, I may not know what God is saying to me, but one thing I do know, if I keep my eyes on him, if I keep my heart in his hand, if I keep trusting my daddy, everything that I didn't understand, it will be understood. He will bring it to the forefront, and he will make it known. Just receive what God has spoken in your life. Receive what God has done for you. Receive it, glory be to God. The first part that you want to bring up, the first part is that you want to know you got an intimate. I'm not talking about just a relationship. I'm talking about one so intimate. And baby, let me tell you something. A man could be sitting around him, but you the one that got the baruch of Bara. He got his hands on you. He got his hands on it. It ain't your mama, it ain't your daddy, it ain't your sister, and it showing up ain't your brother. Because of the fact what God has done for you is for you. What God is bringing forth is coming forth through you. Are you here? But also, I can run, love, Lord, have mercy for your wings. I know, Lord, I get up out this place, but I know the power of the Almighty God. I know the power power of the Almighty God word. I know the power, just like David told him, Lord, because God sent the sin, he sent the prophet out to David, because in fact, you know, David was a shepherd boy, and God made him ruler. Glory be to God. He made him ruler over all Jerusalem, all the Israelites. He brought them all together. You better hear the Holy Spirit. And before the enemy could even took a look around good, God had wiped his enemy out. I know you hear God talking to you. I need you to rise up. I need you to summon your faith. I know that if I can, but God, let me tell you something. You gotta have wisdom, but God do everything with a purpose. He do everything to whereby your mind can be free and sets free. And you don't have to even worry or think. You see, because I'm not a worrier. But see, I am one that concerned. I'm concerned about the body of Christ. I'm concerned that God has moved so supernatural on your behalf that baby is blowing your mind, and God is not finished. And see, as you believe God for that, then you're going to say, I can believe God for this, and I can believe God for this, and I can believe, and it go on and on and on. You know why? Because he's a God that never lies, and he can't die, he can't fail. Are you hearing the Holy Spirit? I want you to latch on like a bulldog. You ready to hear the Holy Ghost with your faith, and you will tell that lying, defeated devil, I shall not be moved. But you're going to separate yourself from any negativity. You're going to separate yourself from anything that don't sound like God, anything that don't look like God. The breakthrough is so mighty. The breakthrough is so powerful. You can't afford to sit around anything that's not productive or not producing. You can't afford to sit around anybody that have what you call doubt kind of faith. You can't afford, glory be to God. You cannot afford for it to happen. You got to rise up in the spirit of God's faith, because God said it like this. He said, rise up, glory be to God, and summon your faith to come alive. Something's already there. The enemy trying to lie to your mind to make you not believe. But I take authority over the works of the devil. I come against it. And tell you something. I'm not just coming against me. David said it like this. You come with your spirit and your sword. You come with your witchcraft. You come with every last one of them. You're going to find them dead with their books kicked up in the air. Because God going to let you see your proving. He said, this is the time now for every prophecy that I've been speaking in your life. It's time now for it to come forth. It's time now for you to bring it. Oh, but it's time. It's time. You better hear the Holy Spirit. God renews. God restores. God do it. Take your faith. You see, because it's what you believe that give God a thing. And if you've been talking like that, that means that my faith is only caught up in God. That means my faith is only in the presence of God. That means my faith, what you said, Pastor Steiner, because of the fact faith is the only thing going to get my daddy's attention. My baruch boy, even Rahab during the time, she was a prostitute. Where is one how you gonna find this prostitute in the lineage of my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ? You better read your Bible, because God is talking to you in him. God is ready for you to come up out of poverty, ready for you to come up out of lack. He's been ready. He's been so ready. His hands itching. Oh my God, for you to come up out of there. But he's not bringing you up out of it, but just for you alone. Oh, it's so many more people that God got. So it's so much on you. Glory be. It's all in my bones that I know that I got to not know. I know that I got to extend the favor of God to so many more people. But God, let me tell you something. Let me listen to the wisdom before I let you go. I said, Lord, he said, no man understand God to the fullness of his. You can't understand God to the full capacity of who God is. You cannot explain this man. But God said, I give you grace that you can hold on, glory be to God, because I'm coming through, and I'm coming through not as man. He said, because of the fact that the God that I'm talking about, no, let me hear the Holy Spirit. No. It's not by man's might. It's not by man's power. It's by the power and the authority of the Almighty God. Don't you know when the fire get hot, that means God is saying, get up, glory be to God. Get up and speak what I speak. Get up and say what I say. Get up and do it the way I do it. Get up what you mean, Pastor Stiver. Do it by faith. Release it by faith. Receive it by faith. Everything, you better hear the Holy Ghost. Receive it by faith. Are you hearing God? Even Moses himself, my Bible said that how even he himself, you know, they worship what you call idol God. That means that there's a God. That God didn't have no ears, can't hear you, because why? They made trees out of there, God. They made stuff out of there, God. And God, rope, rope, boy, God said, no, I am your true and living God. Every last one of the other gods who want to proclaim that they were God, the Bible said every last one of those folks, they dead and gone on home. But guess who living, baby? Jehovah God. Jesus. God, if you take God so much, I can tell you, my God is going to take this world over. Oh, but I feel the power of the presence of God. I feel the power of God's peace. I feel the power. Glory be to God. And it ain't about what you feel. It's about what you know. It's about who you know. Who do you know, baby? Who do you know, baby girl, Bridget? I know a man named Jesus. He never turned his back on you. He'll never leave you standing by yourself. He'll never leave you alone because of the fact he said, I'm with you, Bridget, no matter what. Call your own name out. He said, I am the Lord thy God. I'm your Lord thy God. You got to make him Lord. You got to make him Savior. But you said all that for Pastor Stop. Because let me tell you something. He's not just Savior and saving you from eternal death. Oh yeah, he saved you because of faith. You was getting ready to kill somebody. You was getting ready to have a bad accident. You was getting ready to do something so stupid and say the devil laughed at you. And that's what you do. Oh Lord have mercy, Jesus. He laughs at you because of the fact he know he has it. He know he got you now. Because the fact you listen to the wrong voice, that's why I tell you all, come on, get back where you belong. And that's in the presence of God. Get back, ministry of love. Get back in your place. Get back where God assigned you. Get back to your home. Get back to where God placed you. Get back to repeat God. Get back to where he assigned you. Get back to your home. Get back to it. Oh, but something going on. Lord, have mercy. It's like if I had a racetrack. It's bigger than that. It's like, Lord, if at the wings, I hear my brother David talking, I fly away from here. But he said, guess what? It's not my time. It's not your time. Your time is be prepared because God is moving on your behalf. I want you to just lock hands. Lock hands with your faith, because let me tell you something. It's that faith is going to keep you. It's your faith that's going to keep you rising. It's your faith that's going to keep you up and keep you above. It's your faith. You better hear the Holy Ghost. It's your faith that God is bringing you on top. It's your faith. Let me tell you something. We know about Rahab. We know about all these other people in the world that live in God, because they weren't obeying God. But but there was a righteous somebody praying. And God said, I've never seen a righteous forsaken, nor have I ever seen come with my children beg for bread. God got you. Receive it in the name. I'm going to let you go. Receive it in the name of the Father. Receive it in the name of the Son. Receive it in the name of the Holy Ghost. Catch it. Glory be to God. There was a time I know God would show me back to back. So I've always been wealthy in God. Catch the revelation. Always been wealthy in God. I bowed down on my knees. I bowed down with an assurance. I know my daddy hear my prayer when I call. You better hear the Holy Spirit. And that becomes the fact that, oh, you didn't live such a beautiful prayer. No, you better cut that mess off. Because God ain't coming. You think he coming to play with you? He ain't coming to play with you. But yet you want to put everybody down. What's wrong with you? When God had and still had it. So much mercy on me. So much mercy on you. So much of goodness over here in my life. So much of goodness over there where you are. You know where you are. I don't care if you're on your 8. I don't care. You may be driving an 18-wheeler right now. You may be checking out right now, checking your coffee. Either way it goes, God is on your side. And he will never allow you to be Satan. No, Jesus. He will never allow you to be Satan in the hands of your defeat. See, to the enemy, he know he been defeated. One thing about that lying devil, he know I know him. Yeah, just like I know, oh my God, he know me. But you better understand, baby, I know him too. You got to be able to be wise. Come on, smart and wise. Come on, you got to be wise. Come on, smart and wise as a dove. And fly over stuff and look at stuff like, well, whatever, keep moving. Baby, God got you. I want you to receive it. If you don't receive a breakthrough before this week is over and it just done started, baby, you're going to see something. You're going to see the power of God move so. Ooh, Lord. Lord Jesus, on your behalf. You know it was God, because everything tried to get in my way. Trying to get Bridget, did you do this? Did you do this? Did you do that? That's what I know. That's when you know you're on the right track, or you hear the Holy Spirit. You are on the right track. God got you. I just want to shout. If I just get out of this robe and just shout and just shout and just shout and give him glory and give him honor and give him praise, because the power of the Almighty God, my pain would tell me that the Lord thy God, the word of the living God, it never loses its power. The only way you can see it that way is that you walked away from him. And if you don't walk away from him, I promise you, he ain't going nowhere, baby. He gonna stick right there by your side until everything is cleared out. And when everything cleared out, and then he gonna step up and he say, did you see? Did you see? My word is true. Did you see? My word is faithful. Did you see? God is faithful to his word. Are you hearing the Holy Spirit? Take it and run with it. Take it and share. Stop liking, share. Stop share with somebody. Tell somebody else. God is said right now, moving right now on your behalf is a supernatural empower. Oh my God, a supernatural empower. And it's like this empowerment of God. Oh my God, they need to set it out, set it on your behalf. He didn't move for you, he didn't already done it. Let me tell you something, he has dumped the devil already. They don't even know why they got to be good to you. They don't know why they got to give it up to you. They don't know why. I can tell you why. Because my Bible tells me, God told Moses, Moses, that same favor that rests upon you is going to rest upon your people. You better hear the Holy Ghost. There are many times people are asking, you sound just like the impotent. It's a particular one. You sound just like that woman. You sound, you know why? They know the authority, the power, the authority of the Almighty God. They don't know the power, the authority of the word of the living God. They'll know that. Oh God, it's today, it's the day, it's another day. I don't know, I think it's after 3 o'clock in the morning. That's all right. Whenever he calls, you be ready to answer. Are you hearing the Holy Ghost? You be ready to answer. Because the faith, let me tell you something. Everything that Nancy defeated for thought he did himself some justice, that tried to come in and try to do this. But you about to see something. Oh, but you about to see some things I can't even explain it. Matter of fact, it's so much of God, it's no explaining that you have. When it come down to my father, because my daddy, he give you a portion of his mind. You have it because the Holy Spirit is in you. And he's the one that's making sure everything is ran God's way and not your way. God got you, my babies. I love you. I can preach to you till the sun go down. But baby, God is a God of wisdom. He gives you enough where you can stand still and you can be bold. You can speak his word out of your mouth. Speak it, glory be to God. Speak it out of your mouth. God said, I receive everything that you say to me from your heart. He don't want no lip service. Are you hearing the Holy Spirit? He want what's coming from the heart. He want, if it's in your heart, that's what he wants. He wants that close connection from the heart. He wants that close relationship from the heart. He wants everything that he's doing, he's done. He wants it from your heart. And that's what the enemy been trying to do. He's been trying to sneak at that nasty, low down, defeated devil. He's you better watch him, because he's baby. I mean, he's older, way ages up. He's older than we are. But guess what, baby? If you ever get acquainted, and that's what God challenged you to do, get acquainted with my father. Get acquainted with his son. Get acquainted with the Holy Ghost. Get acquainted with his word. Get acquainted with it, and you will see the power of God move like never before. Something going on, and God ain't playing. You better see a great explosion that's going to take place. And it's a great explosion of God's goodness, of God's grace, of God's mercy, of God's love. You thought he forgot about you. No, 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 no. He only was testing the level of your faith. Are you ready to take this step? Are you ready to take this step? Are you ready to take this step? You may be saying to yourself, yes, Lord, I am. Because I'm telling you something. There's a many of God's children. They walk out as being a novice. You know what a novice is, right? That's somebody that ain't ready. You're not equipped to go. You ain't ready yet. Your time is your time coming. It's coming. Don't get in a hurry. Don't get in a hurry. Please see the Holy Spirit. Don't get in a hurry. Let God do it. The power of God's resting so upon me this morning. All I can do is tell God, thank you, Father. thank you so, because you're a man to your word. God loved you. I loved you too, but he loved you the most. That's what's so significant about it. I tell you like he said these words, and I'm going to read it, and you take it, ponder on it, hear the word, read the word, meditate on the word. Are you hearing the Holy Ghost? Believe what you speak. Believe. Oh, Jesus. Believe it. Believe. You know what I told? I tell everybody, anybody, all about it. I won't bow down to a God that I don't trust. Are you? Oh, Jesus. Trust the Lord with all your heart. Lean not to your own understanding. It ain't for you to understand everything. But baby, God expected you to trust him in everything. Are you here? That's why I'm like, get up in the morning. That God, he rolls me up. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you for my right mind. Thank you for my health, my strength. Thank you, Father. Lord, I thank you. Because that's what the world, that's what the devil wants you to do. He wants you to throw it all in the air. Like, forget it. He did it to Jesus. Now he want to do it to you. He want to say, oh, look at all of this that you can have if you do this and if you do that. But see, a wise person, they'll catch it. It'll take something. Truth comes three ways. Now, sooner or later. And see, once you get that down pat, and God heard you over that, I'm teaching something, my baby. You know God in a special way. You know God in a way that I'm oh my God. You know him in a way to worry about. Everybody talking, but you're in tune with God. Your spirit, you're in tune with it. You can hear him. He's talking. He might be talking against the crowd. He ain't saying nothing to the crowd. The crowd be the crowd. Then you begin to move and talk. Man, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to do that. I didn't mean to say that. I didn't mean that. And guess what? Ain't nothing greater than my Father. Now let's close this prayer out. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, through by the power of your word. Father, through by the power of your blood. Father, through by the power of the Holy Spirit. Father, I come lifting up your name. I thank you, Lord God. I see all these little trippy booby traps. But every last one of them been cursed. You will not be deceived. You will not be manipulated. You will not be caught off guard. You will not. You will sniff a devil before he can even enter the room. Oh, but it's real. It's real, babies. It's real all the way. You can't afford. You can't afford. It's too much. It's too much. You cannot afford to try to carry other folks' stuff. No, baby, you're not built for that. That's God's job. It's up to you to say, here, God, here, God, I take it to you. What's happened? That means you've freed yourself up from whatever it is thought it had you bowed down to. You're free, baby. You're free in the things of God. He loves you so much that God the Father, that God the Son, God the Holy Ghost, he got you, baby. He loves you, baby. He got you. Even if they were trying to use you to do foolish things, that's all right, baby. God's dear loves you. He loves you. Now, gotta let you go. Gotta let you go. Gotta let you go. Look at this here. This here thing here. It's healing so fast. I'm gonna show you something. Look at this here. This thing was so bad. I want you to see something. I want you to see how God ain't playing. I need you to see this. Let's see this. You see this right here? You see that right there? You can see that? Oh, I hope you can. Can you see it? The devil tried to sever it. But he couldn't touch Bridget. I release the same anointing of God's grace upon you. I release the same anointing of God's favor. I release it upon you that you can walk in a great anointing. A greater, he never give a decrease. He always give an increase. Are you hearing the Holy Spirit? God gets the last word. Baby, don't get discouraged. The man is with you. He's with you. And he asks you a question. How you wanna go? Lord, I want to go. Lord, you know what? I'm going to go so high until when I look down. Like, Lord, look at the humans. Look at them, Lord. Have mercy on them. Have mercy upon us all. Every man, woman, boy, and girl. Hear all the Mr. Morgan. I hear the Holy Spirit. That's why that book, you see that? See, God has graced me now. He said, that's not coincidental. For you have everything set up in my house. Everything set up, I built the whole studio. The studio's for everything God need to work through with. From the radio to the TV to the letters to the this. Because the fact, you know why? Baby, if I could tell you, you don't need God. Because you can do it on your own. But see, you need God. You think about him all day long. All day long. Because you love him. And you love him just that much. All right. I love you all. A little long-winded or not, it don't matter. You stayed in the ballroom until 5 o'clock. They had to put you all if it was 6 o'clock. So guess what? Now, you're in a place that's filled with value. It's filled with love. It's filled with it just fills you with so much joy. It's just so much of his presence. Just fuse with it, and you walk with it, and nobody don't understand it, but you walk with it, you walk with it, and every day you make that confession, and you begin to tell God those words, and you begin to say, Lord, but I thank you, Lord, but I thank you, Lord, but I thank you. Now, my job been done. I can get up here now. I can fly like an eagle. You're one of the most richest women you ever laid your eyes on. You ain't seen nothing yet. I swore to you. You ain't seen nothing yet. Watch God. That's because of the fact you want to elevate your faith. You want to elevate your faith. You want to elevate. That's what he wants. He wants your faith. Lucifer said, he tried to sneak in and steal Peter's faith. And God told that lying devil, you can try all you want. You won't go nowhere yet. You can't prevail here. You can't prevail here. Because who am I holding the palm of my hand? Can't nobody pluck him out. Are you hearing the Holy Spirit? No, baby. They can't pluck you out of his hand, baby. Just stay with him. Stay connected. Stay close by. Stay with him. Walk with him every day. Talk with him every day. Even before you go to bed, I still can. Like the man on my mind. He's on my mind and my heart. The man on my mind. He's in my heart. He knows that that's all. Long that time, oh Lord, I thank you so much. God loves you. God bless you, soldiers. You're soldiers, but guess what? Ain't that crazy? You're a soldier, but you don't have to fight. What makes sense? A whole lot of sense. That mean God said, He said, I fight. Just like you told Peter. Peter, the devil ain't thinking about your home, ain't thinking about your car. That's just like elementary. He said, stay with me, boy. He said, just like I feed the birds in the air. Stay with me, boy. He said, I'm going to show you taking care of. Don't you worry about a thing. I got you, girl. Call your name up. I got you, Bridget. I got you. I got you. Sharon, I got you. I got you. Mia, I got you. Terry, I got you. Call your man on me. Oh, he got you. 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 Oh, but I love you. And I gotta let you go. God bless you all, my sweetheart. Thank God for my little boy. You ain't never crying to your mama, you ain't know. You ain't never crying to your mama, baby. And PJ is my only son. And God using him like crazy. Managing the word, the living God. Princess, God love her so much. He love that baby so much that baby could breathe. Like Jesus said, well, yeah, what you want, baby? What you want? Yeah, you belong to Bridget, and everything that belongs to Bridget is blessed. Everything that comes from Bridget is blessed. Well, yeah, Chandra, she's blessed. Everything came from Bridget, blessed. Now I love you from the bottom of my heart. You hear the word? You read the word? You just hear in your heart. He's in here. He's in your heart. Hear, read it, study, meditate. What's the next one? Memorize it. I love you with all the little heart that I have in Virgin. I love you. And that's what matters. I love you, my baby. God bless you. Your little life will never be the same. God loves you.
Order your copy of What Makes Christians So Hypocritical today at bridgeside.com, Amazon, Target, Walmart, or any other book retailers. Copies are also available for download.